You bet, just like his dad.
Oh, but his eyes. They're just like his mother's.
Now come out.
Come out. Come out.
No, sir. In my house. I'm the boss.
Sono io la padrona della casa. Siamo in America.
Getting for Swiss cheese?
Oh, 50 cents a pound, madam.
50 cents? Why, across the street at Tannenbaum's, it's only 35 cents.
Then why didn't you get it from him?
Because he hasn't got any.
If I didn't have any, I'd sell it for a quarter.
Oh, this is the last time I'll ever come into your store.
And if I never see you again, that's soon enough for
and
me.
And I'll tell everybody I'm going back to come in your store.
I belong.
How's business?
This is a fine neighborhood. A man can't even make a living. We try to be decent. Molly, by golly.
I was only fooling, Eric, dear.
You know, Molly, I thought you were one of those sad little kids. But you can have anything you want. You know that.
You're too good to me, Eric. You know, life's pretty tough all alone, and I don't know what I'd do without you. Why, you've been just like a mother and father. rolled into one.
And Molly, you're a little angel rolled into two. Don't forget, the supper's on me tonight.
Fine. I think Dee's expecting Eddie.
That's great. The more the merrier. I'm going to bring everything. And also a grand surprise.
Eric, what is it?
You wait and I'll show you, Molly.
Oh, Eric, tell me what it is now.
No, I wouldn't tell you now, Molly.
All right. Have the papers come yet?
Yes, here they are. Take mine up, too.
Certainly, pal. Fill that up.
Certainly, gal. Take five.
We'll be waiting, Eric. Don't be long.
As soon as I shut my store, I'll be right up, Molly.
Nobody knows where I am.
Say, Dee, these things are dry enough. Let's take them back. Say, Eric's buying supper tonight.
That's the kind of a neighbor to have. The kind that gives and gives till it hurts.
He's an old dear.
Uh-huh. You're Eddie's coming tonight, isn't he?
Yes. Tonight's my night with Eddie.
Yes, and so are the other 364.
Oh.
Is he still trying to write songs?
Only trying.
Who's taking you to the block party tonight? It's only downstairs. Do I have to lean on someone to get there?
Well, what about the floor walker at the store?
He may mean the world to Macy, but to me, he's a shooting pain.
You're a chump. Be nice to him. And you're a cinch to wind up at the perfume counter.
So what's the perfume counter? Just another job.
I wish I had it. Gee, I smell grand.
Well, now that John Gilbert's married, who is your suppressed desire? Rin Tin Tin. Stop fooling. You're so hard to please. Who would you go for?
Something on this order.
So that's it, is it? Tea is served.
You know, Bee, there's a song that expresses my feelings exactly.
There's an old one that expresses mine, too. If the rain makes the flowers beautiful, why don't it rain on me?
It's well, to some it's hell, to some it's only what love can bring. Please don't blame me if I'm human too. and you.
For a new song. Get this, Molly. Get this, B. When there are gray skies, my boy, I don't mind the gray skies, my boy. Well, it sounds sort of familiar, but it gets different as it goes along. It all came to me in a dream last night. What do you think of it?
You're not awake yet.
That's the trouble with you. You never encourage me.
Well, you never offered to jump out of a window.
You burn me up. I come up here every night.
You
have
no right to
see you, and then you burn me up.
There
I am.
Oh, hello, Eric.
Oh, there's Eric.
Oh, look at Eric.
I brought a
pickle. Oh, my God.
You help yourself, and I'll put it in the ice.
Look at pickles. Oh,
it's good.
I bet it's good. Oh, look at
that. Let's
see the big
holes. Will you please cut that out? We have to eat that.
Oh, look at the big fishes.
Stop it, Bee! Stop it! You're getting me all mixed up.
Go on and go get the chair.
All right, honey, I'll get them. Just a minute.
Now come here. Now comes the grand surprise.
What, Eric?
Now you wait and see.
What is it, Eric?
That ain't it. I know that's good. I made it myself. You know, I drank 3 gallons of this and I didn't stagger.
You didn't stagger?
I couldn't even move.
Oh.
You should have seen me, see?
Let's get these things set
Eric,
here, huh?
Yes. How old is this beard?
As old as it's going to get.
Let's all sit down, huh? Well, anybody that don't like this life is crazy. I tried them all, and this is the best.
I wonder what the poor people are doing.
Oh.
Who cares, man? Here goes number one.
All right.
I think I'm one. Will you and Jane do your song now?
All right, Mother.
Lake.
Yes, madam?
Don't serve any drinks for a minute. Mr. Jack and Miss Worth are going to do a song for us.
Yes, madam.
Do it well now, sweetheart. Everyone is watching you.
All right. I'm ready.
When I start in petty, you say that daddy isn't what it ought to be for love. Love, dear, you drive me frantic. You're too darn romantic. We don't need the moon and stars above. Put two lovers in a fond embrace. They should worry over time and play.
That's what I'd love to do forever, Jane.
Oh, that was a great tune, Jack. Play it again.
Now?
Yes, now.
I hate to think of you getting married, dear.
Don't worry. When I do, I'm not going to let it take me out of circulation.
You darling.
Oh, Jane, I'd like to speak to you for a moment, if you can lose that taillight of yours.
Pardon me.
That's a fine way to talk to a person in your own home.
Some persons demand more attention than others.
Jack, you're impossible.
Might I mention that I saw that kiss?
You know, Jack, this is not 1890. What's a kiss?
Your kisses mean a lot to me, Jane. Oh, I'm so in love with you. Why can't we get married and get away from all this?
I might marry you, but I want to have a little fun first.
Come on, Jane, let's dance.
May I, Jack?
Just as you like.
These are cocktails, sir.
I know it. I don't know. Anywhere. I'll see you later.
He'd better hurry up. The block party starts for you soon, and here we are still in the kitchen.
That's a great idea for a song. There they are, in the street, boys and girls with dancing feet. And here are we, in the kitchen.
Fine guy to handle dishes. Where do you think we get our money, out of a pump? Go away. I handle this one. You know very well. Now, you see, that's what you should not do.
That's all, boys.
Gee, I'm going down to see what's going on. Excuse me, will you please, Eddie?
Say, what are you in such a hurry for? There's a fire.
Aren't you coming down now, Molly?
No, you go on. I'm going to change my dress.
See you downstairs, Molly.
All right, Dee.
Good to see you there.
Yeah, see you later.
Bye.
Now, don't be too long. There's going to be a hot time in the old town tonight.
That gives me a great idea for a song.
Nice of you to take me to the block party this evening. Oh, I'm not quite ready. Would you mind waiting while I change? What should I wear? Would you like me best in my cerise? Or should I wear my black and silver?
You don't like cerise? And you don't like black and silver? Then you don't want to go with me.
To blame?
Why, sure.
I saw everything. Little Angie Brady ran into the middle of the street in front of his car. Then he had a trunk fixed to keep from hitting her.
Oh, these rich guys think they can get away with murder.
Now, wait a minute, boys. Now, listen. We don't want to have no fighting on a night like this. Everybody's going to have a good time. Now, I fixed everything. You come with me, young man. Someone clipped you, eh?
Yes, I guess so.
I tell you what you do. You go up to my room. It's on the fourth floor, the right door. I'll take care of your car.
Thank you.
Say, do me a favor, will you, Charlie?
Yes.
Take the car around the block.
I'll tell you, I'll leave it right in front of the garage for you.
That's good.
Hey, kid.
Come on, Billy. Get off the car. Get off the car.
did you get here?
I was directed here. I've had an accident.
Oh. Oh, you're hurt. Oh, just a minute. Is that the accident I saw downstairs?
Yes. I nearly hit a little girl. I got out pretty lucky, too, because I really wasn't thinking of what I was doing.
There. It'll be all right.
Thank you.
You lie down and take it easy. It's not very bad.
I'm all right. I was just shaken up a bit.
Yes, I know. But you'll feel better after you rest a while.
Thank you.
Haven't I met you someplace before?
Maybe. I've been someplace before. Where was it?
Palm Beach. Southampton.
I live at Southampton. I've just come from there.
Well, why should you leave there on a hot night like this?
Well, to tell you the truth, I had a quarrel with my girl.
Oh. Then you have a girl.
No, I haven't. That is, she doesn't love me the way I love her.
Is she very wonderful?
Very wonderful.
And do you love her very much?
Very much.
And I suppose you never look at another girl.
Never.
That's just the trouble.
What do you mean?
You ought to make her jealous.
I wouldn't know how.
Sit down. I've got to leave you for a minute. Don't move. The block party's starting downstairs, and I've got to sing a song. You can watch it from up here. Wait, I'll be right back.
Thank you. gentlemen, the man who's responsible for this block party is our popular undertaker, Joe Vito, who furnished us with all the ice cream and the frankfurters. Get it? He will be master of ceremonies. If you don't know Joe, ladies and gentlemen, someday you will. Joe Vito.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 4th of July is a big day in American history. Never forget what you were learned at school, them inspiring words of our national anthem. Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so and how so? Well, anyway, the first act on the program will be by a couple of kids who have entertained you many times in the past. Eddie Rafferty and B. Nichols.
Oh, my cookie! It's me, folks, it's me! Hello, Mike! Hello, Mary, how are you?
How's your mother?
All right, Joe.
I wake up each morning, where do I go? Up to the hill, where the wildflowers grow. Ask me why I go there, what do I do? Can't you guess, it's all because of you. You got me picking petals off a daisy. Some say yes, some say no. You'll find me picking petals off a daisy. Everywhere they grow. Oh, to tell the truth, I'm acting kind of crazy. Oh, the keeper follows everywhere I go. But you can stop me picking petals off the daisies if you tell me what I want to know.
I've a little secret I thought I'd keep. I'm up at dawn when I should be asleep. You say you pick daisies, I pick them too. In a field a frosty way from you, you've got me picking petals off a daisies. Some say yes and some say no. You'll find me picking petals off a daisies everywhere they grow.
We will now hear from now...
Another rotten chestnut!
Little Jerry McGinnis will recite for you a piece that no doubt you've all heard in your day.
Another rotten chestnut!
Little Jerry McGinnis will recite for you.
Under the spreading chestnut tree, the village smithy stands. The smith, the mighty man is he, with large and sinewy hands, and the muscles of his brawny arms are strong as iron. Yeah!
The little boy had an appointment. You will next be entertained by a little girl you all know and love, Molly Carr, who will sing a little song for you. Molly.
Think of when you're blue. There are others much worse off than you. If a load of trouble should arise, just laugh and say it's great to be alive. Keep your sunshine up, up high, the sky that gets blue. If you can fry lobster and cake, you're in luck, your tummy won't ache. So keep your funny side up, up. Let your laughter come through. Do, if you meet with gloom, don't fall down, go boom. Keep your sunny side up. Keep your sunny side up, up. Hide the side that gets blue. If you have nine sons in a row, baseball teams make money, you know. So keep your funny side up, up. Let your laughter come through. Do stand up on your legs, be like two fried eggs. Keep your sunny side up.
We have good times, don't we? All right, then. Let's see y'all smile. That's great. Now, we'll all sing a chorus of Sunnyside Up. What do you say?
Yeah.
All right, Joe. Come on, everybody. What's the matter with you? Come on, give out a big smile. Come on. That's it. A little more. Bigger. 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 That's it. That's it. All together now.
Keep your sunny side up, up, high, the sky that gets
Eric Swenson, the neighborhood grocer, will now entertain. Eric?
Let it go, Joe.
Come down to Southampton and let me put you in the charity show we are doing. You'd be a tremendous hit.
Oh, no, I wouldn't. I might get by here, but well, down there, I wouldn't fit in.
Well, I'll arrange that. You'd fit in if you came down as my guest. And Mother's down there, and she'd look out for you.
Oh, that'd be fine. But I couldn't. It's impossible.
Well, what's to stop you?
Well, there's my job, and Eric might object. Oh, let's talk about something else.
Gee, it would be great if you'd come. We need someone wonderful like you.
Well, isn't your girl in it?
Yes, but you'd do the main specialty if you'd come.
Well, wouldn't that make her jealous?
Great. Remember what you just told me? We'd be killing two birds with one stone.
She'd never be jealous of me that way.
Huh. Don't fool yourself. In gorgeous clothes and a proper setting, you'd make any girl jealous.
Oh, it's all too impossible. Stop dreaming.
I can just picture Jane when you and I sing the love song together. Come on. Say you'll do it. Please. Aha! I've been looking for you. What are you doing in her room? I see that clip on the head wasn't hard enough.
Oh, no, Eric, you're wrong. This gentleman wants to take me to Southampton.
I know the type is usually Atlantic City. And I suppose your wife don't understand you.
I'll explain. I heard Miss...
The car?
Miss Carr sing. And I'd like to put her in our charity show. And to prove there's nothing wrong, you can come down with her.
Well, what about us?
Well, if you're friends of hers, you can come down too.
Molly, what did you say to all this?
I said it was up to you, Eric.
Well, now, that's a different story. Go ahead, young man. Make up my mind.
I think you'd be glad to get away from the city. Here it's hot, and down there it's cool. Here you have the roar of the elevators, and down there you have the low rumble of the surf. Here you have electric signs, and down there you have moonlight. They'll be bathing and dancing. Why, it'll be a regular lark.
That's all very well, but what about our job?
This is a vacation with pay.
Say, what about my store?
We'll close it for a month. Now, give her whatever you'd make.
In that case, I owe you $40.
I know where I head in, and it ain't Southampton.
Oh, don't be like that. You'll have the time of your life. I'll lease a McDonald house for you. It's right next to ours. I'll get the clothes, the servants, and everything.
That's the only part I don't like. I'd be scared to death of the servants.
I've got it. We'll be the servants. Eric, Eddie, and I. Eddie can drive, and I'll be the cook and personal maid.
And I'll be the house detective.
Stop kidding. Then it's all settled. We'll go to Wanamaker's and order whatever you'll need.
Hooray! I'm a lady at last. Eric, the beer, please.
Yes, madam.
Come on, come on, come on. Molly, I'll be your maid. Oh, come on, come on. This is a great 4th of July.
That gives me a great idea for a song. You lied to me when you said you loved me.
Who is this girl you're so interested in, Jack?
Well, I'll tell you, Mother. She's taken the McDonald house next door. I met her in New York, and she was very kind to me. And I'd like to do something for her in return.
What do you want me to do, dear?
Give a little reception for her and have her meet everybody.
A young girl coming here alone? Where are her parents?
They were killed in the war.
Both of them?
No, 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 no.
She must have a family.
Of course she has a family. And what a family. You know the cars, the Detroit cars?
Oh, yes. I know them well.
Not these cars.
How do you know which ones I mean?
I don't care which ones you mean.
What?
I mean, they've been very exclusive.
Oh.
Mother, she's lovely. So clever and sings beautifully. And that's the point. If we handle it carefully, we might be able to induce her to sing in the charity carnival.
Well, anything for you and sweet charity's sake.
Mother, you're a darling. Hello, Eric.
I beg your pardon, sir. Who did you wish to see?
Why, Molly.
I'll tell Miss Carr. Your name, please? Very well, madam. Miss Carver, see you.
Thanks, Eric.
You don't need a hat check. I'll remember you.
Hello, Molly.
Oh, Mr. Cromwell. So nice of you to call. We're hardly settled yet. But of course, the house is always open to an old friend.
Oh, Raspberry, what is all this? Hello, Jack, old pal, old boy, old boy.
Hello, Eddie.
How is the big boy?
Hello, Pete. How are you?
Come on, have a cigar.
No, thank you, Eric. Molly, you're wonderful. You're more of a lady than any lady I know. Now, here's the plan. It's all set about your part in the charity show. You'll do two songs, the love duet with me and your specialty song. And we'll start rehearsing right away.
Oh, I'm nervous already.
You mustn't be. I just spoke to Mother, and she's giving a tea for you Monday afternoon. And by Tuesday morning, you'll know everybody in town.
Oh, that's wonderful. Oh, but I hate to think about being there all alone. I mean, without Eric and Eddie and B.
Don't worry about us. We'll get in.
How are we going to crash the gate? This ain't the chauffeur's ball, you know.
We're going in the back way. One or two servants more or less wouldn't be noticed, would they, Jack?
Great. Then it's all settled. Jack, Mr. Cromwell, everything you are doing for us is so wonderful. Words can express my feelings. Every time I think of it, a feeling comes over me that, I don't know. All I can say is, it makes me feel like the Brooklyn Bridge.
How's that?
That I couldn't tell you.
You'll take care of the wants of the guests on the beach. You understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
What have you done with your other cuff? Pull it down and see that it stays down. That's better. What a mess. Fix your coat. Look at your tie.
Yes, look at it. Isn't it beautiful?
Stop that. Where have you ever been a servant before? You haven't the manner of a servant. You haven't the dignity of a servant. You ought to be ashamed of yourself. Oh, get up.
Get up.
And you?
I know what to do.
Very well, then. See that you do it. You, my dear, you stay close to me.
Yes, Mr. Lake. I get it.
That should give you a great idea for a song.
Ah, shut up.
That's enough. Get along now, get along. The guests are arriving. Hurry up, hurry up.
How do you do, Miss Carr?
How do you do?
Miss Carr.
How do you do,
Miss Catherine?
May I present Miss Molly Carr?
Molly, dear, this is Miss Catherine.
How do you do?
How do you do?
How do you do? Molly, dear, should we go down here? Excuse us for a moment.
Certainly.
Sure.
Gee, this is great down here. I wish it could last forever.
Well, it'll last 2 months anyway.
How do you know?
Mr. Cromwell gave Molly a check for 2 months' rent this morning.
He did?
Uh-huh.
Oh, boy, that's
can
great.
Can you see it?
Then I'll see you tonight, Marilyn.
All right, dear.
Goodbye.
I just met Miss Carr, a delightful little person, most charming.
Really? Jane, you two should know each other. Molly, this is Miss Worth. Jane, dear, will you look after Miss Carr for a moment?
How do you do?
How do you do?
You're the girl Jack, Mr. Cromwell, is in love with, aren't you?
Did he discuss that with you?
Yes, and if you don't mind my saying so, I think you're a very lucky girl to have the love of a man like Jack Cromwell.
Oh, you do? By the way, I hear you're from Detroit.
Yes, I am.
Who do you know there?
Oh, the Ford. And the Dodges. And
the Hopmobiles?
No, I never met them.
Won't you have a lemonade?
No, thank you.
A sandwich?
No, thank you.
A cocktail?
No, thank you.
They say the water is nice and warm today. How about a little dip?
No, thank you. I don't want anything.
Well, then, I'll see you later, Miss Worth. Goodbye. Oh, thanks, Eric, dear.
It was nothing, madam. Darn that collar.
I don't know what this house is coming to, what with the people they're inviting.
What do you mean?
Our guest of honor today, this Miss Carr.
She seems a nice little thing. What's wrong with her?
Master Jack doesn't think there's anything wrong with her. I just heard her maid say he's paying her rent.
Go on. Really?
So help me.
Madam.
What are you going to wear tonight, Mary?
I don't know.
How do you like it as far as you've gone, Molly?
It's lovely. When I first came down here, I was nervous about it all. But now I feel I would have missed it for the world.
I'm glad of that.
And I have you to thank for it.
Don't you dare be grateful to me. You're the one that's helping me out. And by the way, Jane is hovering up, so if I suddenly make mad love to you, listen to me as if you loved every word of it.
All right, Jack. That's just the way I'll listen.
Hello, girls. How was the water? Fine.
Fine. Fine. Fine.
There you are. There you are.
There
you are. There you are. Can I help you with that, miss?
Why, thank you.
Cocktails, ladies.
Oh, yes, please.
Here's your sandwich, madam.
You're an excellent servant. How did you remember me?
I never forget a face.
We haven't known each other very long, have we, Molly?
Not long enough, Jack.
I'm afraid to know you much longer.
Why afraid?
Because each day, each hour, I learn something new about you that makes you nearer, dearer to my heart.
Oh, you mustn't say such things, Jack.
Why not? Don't you care for me? Just a little?
From the moment I met you, even before I met you, I cared for you. You were always my dream man.
Yes? Yes?
You know, all girls have an ideal man. And mine was a strong man. It was gentle. A handsome man that didn't know it. And then he came along. You came along, Jack. And you had my heart, whether you wanted it or not.
You darling.
Jack, I'd like to speak to you for a moment. If you can find the time.
Why, certainly. Would you excuse me for a moment, Molly?
Certainly, Jack.
It's a good thing I came along. You were making a holy show of yourself.
Why, what do you mean?
The idea of making love to that girl before all these people.
Well, what's wrong with that? She's a nice girl.
The very idea. I saw you deliberately kiss her.
As you said yourself, this is 1890. And what's a kiss?
Oh!
Well, it takes a woman to know a woman. When you suggested making Jane jealous, I was skeptical about it. But she's falling for it beautifully. Beautifully. And Molly, you are marvelous in our love scene. Why, you're a natural born actress. And to think it's working out just the way you predicted. Aren't you happy over it? Molly, aren't you happy over it?
Very happy.
Thing making all us servant stagehands. I wish I was out there on that stage.
What would you do?
I'll show you. Turn on the heat, start in the truck, wiggle and warm up the hut. Oh, it's 30 below.
So you're not going to marry Jack Cromwell after all?
What do you mean?
Well, it looks as if Miss Carr is taking your place.
We'll see about that.
Photograph each day. You should hear the lovely things I say. What I thought, how happy I would be if your photograph could talk to me. If I had a talking picture of you, I would run it every time I felt blue. I would sit there in the gloom of my lonely little room and applaud each time you whispered, I love you, love you. On the screen the moment you came in view, we would talk the whole thing over, we two. I would give 10 shows a day and a midnight matinee if I had a talking picture of you.
A talking picture of you. I would run it every time I feel blue. I would sit there in the gloom of my lonely little room and
they sing beautifully together. They sang that song as if they really loved each other.
As if? I happen to know positively there's something between them. I heard he was paying her rent, and I checked up on it and found it was true.
Excuse me a moment, dear. I have to go backstage and see someone about a matter that can't wait.
Jack! You were great in that song, darling. I may as well tell you now. I can't hold out any longer. We'll be married any time you say.
Do you mean it, Jane?
Yes, on one condition, that you make it soon.
Oh, it's too wonderful.
Not now, naughty boy. I'll see you later.
Molly.
Stop it, Jack. You'll mess me all up and I have to go on. What's happened?
It's worked. It's worked. She loves me, and she'll marry me any time I say. And I have you to thank for it.
Oh, that's fine. That's wonderful. I know just how you feel. And you have me to thank for it. I know what you mean, Jack. You're happy. It's everything you've wished for in your life.
I knew you'd be glad about it. I'll see you after a while.
There's something unpleasant that I have to say to you. And unfortunately, I have to say it at this time.
All right. Go on. Say it. Say anything.
I'm a sophisticated woman. And I realize that my son might have a little affair now and then. But I didn't think he'd bring such things into my very home.
What do you mean?
Miss Carr, you know what I mean. What is the gossip of the entire colony has just reached my ears. The affair between you and my son.
Oh, but you're wrong, Mrs. Cromwell. There's no affair between Jack and me.
Miss Carr, we won't discuss it any further. Do you deny that he is paying your rent and your expenses down here?
I'm not denying anything. But it's for a different reason.
Well, we'll let the matter drop. But I think the sooner you leave here, Miss Carr, the better for all concerned.
Oh, but Mrs. Cromwell, it isn't so. It isn't true. And you've got to tell them that. Oh, you've got to tell them.
I'll go back where people aren't so evil-minded. They don't want me. Well, I don't want them. I'll go right now.
That's the way to talk. Don't even do your number.
With all those people inwardly laughing at me and thinking what they think of me, I should say not.
Oh, Molly, come on, you're on next. The show's going great. Everybody's talking about it. Put it over for me now, Molly. This is the happiest moment of my life.
Why, listen. I'm all ready, Jack. I'm coming.
Great.
Don't be a chump. You're not going to do that number.
Oh, but don't you see, Bea? I've got to. He mustn't know. If I can't have his love, at least I don't want his pity. Part of the bargain, and I want to go home.
It's all right.
Oh, please take me home.
It's all right, Molly, darling. Eric will take you home. Here, Bea, take her outside. We'll meet you there. I know who caused this, and I'll tell that guy something.
Yeah. Hello, Eric. Where's Molly?
So, there you are.
Say, listen here, I want to tell you something.
Just a minute, Eddie. I handle this.
What's the matter?
Molly's gone to New York. To a home. Where she belongs. We come down here to do you a favor. And we did it. And now we're through. She's through.
She's gone to New York?
And she's going to stay there.
You mean I won't see her anymore?
That's it.
Well, what's the matter? What's happened?
Nothing's happened. The bargain's over and she's through. And she told me to tell you that she don't like Southampton or anything about it. And that's that. Darn that collar.
And I won't see her anymore. Gee.
Get along, you two. Stop loitering, get busy. What are you doing?
Ah, shut up!
Come on, let's do spray.
Help! Help! Help!
You wait here, I'll get the car.
No, Eddie. I won't take anything of theirs, even if we have to walk.
That's the way I feel about it.
Come on, then. Let's go.
Wait a minute. Here comes something. Maybe we can get a lift. Hey, wait. Wait, will you? You're going to New York?
Yeah.
How about a ride?
Sure. Hop on back.
All right. Come on.
All right, go ahead.
Oh, Eric.
Now, darling, don't forget what you say in the song. Sunnyside up, sunnyside up.
Oh, Eric.
Come in.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Why, you haven't been to bed, sir.
No, Lake. I've had a terrible night.
It was horrible. I shall never forget it.
Lake? You're older than I am. Do you think it's possible for friendship to be stronger than love?
I never thought much of love, sir.
Oh, Lake.
Sir.
Is it possible to wish for something, and when you get it, find out you don't want it?
Yes, sir. It's also possible to get something you didn't wish for.
Jane, you're beautiful. There's no doubt about it. But you don't love me. And I found out during the night that I don't love you. What do you think of that? I wonder if you can ever forgive me, Molly. Probably you don't love me. Then it will be easy for you. But I'm sure of one thing, Molly. I love you, and I'm going to try awfully hard to get you. What do you think of that?
One, Molly. Wanted. Girls to demonstrate corn plasters in shop windows with handsome feet. How are your feet, Molly? The type? Aw, cheer up, Molly. I hate to see you like this. I'll liven you up. Watch me.
I've got great news for you.
What?
I've got my old job back.
No.
Yes. I told you they couldn't get along without me.
Oh, you.
And what do you think? I saw the sales manager, and he said if you girls would come in, he'd take care of you. How is that for good news?
Gee, that's great, Eddie.
Gee, Molly, doesn't that cheer you up?
Oh, of course. Thanks, Eddie.
Hello, Eddie.
Hello, Eric.
Hello, Molly. I saw these on a wagon downstairs, and I thought that you might like them.
Oh, thank you, Eric. They're lovely.
I know you wonder what I'm doing here, Molly.
Yes, I do.
I had something to tell you. Something very important.
Something important to tell me?
I love you, Molly. I didn't realize it before, but I love you, and I want you to marry me.
That's a very pretty speech, Jack. But it doesn't ring true. I've heard about you, gentlemen. You're brought up to do the right thing. Well, the right thing won't do in this case. And I just want you to know one thing. No matter what's happened, don't try to square it by marrying me. I won't have your pity, do you understand? I won't have your pity.
Oh, Molly, you're wrong. I tell you I love you.
Oh, stop it. Why, you were in the seventh heaven last night when Jane accepted you. You couldn't change overnight.
I tell you, I love you.
You don't.
I tell you, I do. I love you more than anything in this world. And I must have you. And I will have you.
Go away. Go away, I tell you. You've hurt me enough as it is. Oh, go away. Go away.
Very well, Molly. I'll go. But I hope you find out how wrong you are before you ruin both our lives.
I thought so. Why doesn't he mind his own business and stay out of here? Oh, what did he do, dear?
He asked me to marry him.
Well, what the hell are you crying about? That's not such a tough break.
But you don't understand, Beach. He doesn't love me, and so I can't let him know that I love him.
Jack
Cromwell was here, and now Molly's on her way to Southampton. Someone should have gone with her.
The dirty dog. What's he up to now? You get your hat, Bee. Come on, Eddie.
Wait a minute. Are you going all the way down to Southampton?
For her, I'd go to Alaska.
That gives me a great idea for a song. I'll ask her if she loves me. I'll ask her to be mine.
Jack! I've been looking for you. That's why I came over here. And I'm glad I did. Last night, I heard some gossip about you and Molly, and I advised her to leave.
What?
But I've just found out that I was wrong about her.
Oh, you should have known you were wrong, Mother.
Yes, dear, I know. She's a dear little thing, and I want you to go to her and make it up any way you can.
I've just been to her, Mother. I'm afraid it's too late.
Oh, my dear, I'm sorry. So sorry.
Jack, sing it again.
If I had a talking picture of you, I would run it every time I felt blue. I would sit there in the gloom of my lonely little room.
Would you applaud each time I whisper, I love you? Oh, I love you.
On the screen, the moment.